Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Hope everybody will be fine. So today our topic is about the inventories for the manufacturing concerns. In our previous lectures, we studied about the components of the cost, material cost, labor cost, and direct expenses. Material was further divided into two categories. Direct material and indirect material. The labor was also divided into two categories, direct labor and indirect labor, and expenses was also divided into two categories, direct expenses and indirect expenses. Similarly, indirect expenses or overheads were further divided into factory overhead, office and administrative overhead, and selling and distribution overhead. Now, direct material and indirect material. So the difference between direct material and indirect material, I will shortly review my previous lecture. So direct materials are those material which are the essential part of the finished goods, and they are also the dominant part of the finished goods, and we can assign the per unit cost to them. So that is called direct material cost. Indirect materials, that they are not the dominant part of the finished goods. Direct material cost examples are, just like we will take the examples of the shirt. So cloths in shirt, that is direct materials. Indirect material examples, like we have a register. So the glue that are used, that is indirect material cost. Similarly, if we are making the production, so the lubricants, the nut and bolts of the machinery, that is indirect materials. Similarly, direct labor and indirect. So direct labor are those labors. Labor doesn't mean that we can say that mazdoor. No. Labors may be upper level management also, but wages, that is called labor. So direct labors are those labors which are directly involved in the manufacturing of goods as well as by providing services. For example, a cobbler amend the shoes, so cobbler is direct labor. Similarly, teacher, they are providing services, direct labor. Doctor, providing services, direct labor. Engineering, they are providing services, direct labor. Indirect labor means they are indirectly involved in the productions of goods and as well as in the providing the services. For example, teacher is a direct labor, but the administration's personnel, that are indirect labor. Other expenses, so some are direct expenses and some are indirect expenses. So direct expenses are those which are directly involved, and we can calculate their amount in the, and we can assign it to the finished goods. Indirect, which we can't properly assigning it. So these are indirect expenses per unit. Indirect expenses is further divided into three categories: factory, office administration, selling and distribution. So where these expenses taken place, So we will like if that are taken place in the factory, like light, power, heat. These are what's factory overhead. That is called factory overhead. Or indirect factory expenses. Similarly, if indirect these costs took place in the office administration, so that is called administrative overhead. For example, the stationery in the administration office, the administration salaries, the administration light and power, and so on. Similarly, selling and distribution. So when these expenses took place, that is called selling and distribution overheads, like the salesperson salary, the some advertisement cost, distribution, etc. So that is considered as an indirect. Today our topic is inventories for manufacturing concern. So, dear students, the manufacturing business, first of all, what does it mean by manufacturing business? Manufacturing business is that business which involves in manufacturing or in the productions of the finished goods. Such business is called manufacturing business. We can, in simple words, we can define those business which are involved to convert raw materials to finished goods through by a proper process. Such business is called manufacturing business. Har haga business chikum business the mawad kham na finished goods jodawulu ki involved we haga business tamunga sawayu, that business is called manufacturing business. What is called merchandise business? So merchandising business is that business which involves in the selling and buying of the finished goods. They are not involved in the production. They are not involved in the manufacturing process. They just only sold out. They purchase or buy the finished goods and sold out further at the finished goods. Merchandising business, haga business ta weli shi chi kam pa manufacturing ki involved nui. Sirap finished goods akhli or finished goods sold out kai. That is called what's merchandising business. So in the manufacturing business, there are three inventory accounts. Raw material accounts, work in process account, and finished goods account. Raw material account, this inventory account are also sometimes called materials account or direct materials account or and supplies account or store account, because we are storing the raw material in the store, and after the store we issued the raw material for the process. So that's why these are also called supplies account or stores account. That reflects the cost of raw materials and factory supplies that will be consumed in the manufacturing process. So one account is raw material account. Second one is work in process inventory, but I will give you the example of the raw material. Like in cement factory, what are the raw material? So the stones are the raw materials. To manufacture a ballpoint or a marker, so the raw materials are plastic. In garments manufacturing factory, raw material is cloth. wool, yarn. In furniture manufacturing company, the raw material is wood. In leather manufacturing products, like leather coats, boots, shoes, etc., raw material is leather. Hope you will understand the raw materials. Now, dear students, comes towards the work in process. So, work in process inventory, this account reflects the cost of the raw material plus direct labor and manufacturing overhead. Manufacturing overheads. Goods which are manufacturing has started. So, but has not been completed at the end of the fiscal period, at the time. So that is called work in process. Work in process inventory, we can define that work in process inventory is that amount of the raw materials on which some work should take place. So this inventory is neither raw material is neither finished goods. That is between the raw material and the finished goods inventory. Work in process consists of raw material plus direct labor and plus manufacturing overhead. Manufacturing overhead means our other indirect expenses, like when we start work in process on the raw material, so automatically through by machinery that work will take place. So machinery need power to run, fuel to run. Similarly, repair and maintenance will also take place. The depreciation will also be included here. Nut, bolt, etc. That's why manufacturing overhead. So what is work in process? Work in process is what? That when the from store, the raw material is transferred to machinery. And on those raw material, when comes to machinery, so machinery will run by labor. Machinery also need electricity for the operation. Machinery also need some repair and maintenance work. So this is what's the work in process inventory. So work in process is what we can consider that this is neither raw material and neither finished goods. Clear? Next one is finished goods inventory. Finished goods inventory account reflects the cost of the goods manufactured that have been completed and they are ready for the sales. Such inventory that is called finished goods. Look it, when raw material is transferred to work in process unit, so on work in process unit some process taken place that is called work in process. When that work in process is complete, so at the end finished goods are maintained. And when finished goods are maintained, so those finished goods will be packing and the packing and packaging of those should take place and will be stored in the warehouse. And from the warehouse that is delivered to the and distributed to the market. I will give you an example like raw material, we purchase wood from a farmer or from a forester. Those woods we transfer to our manufacturing unit. When we transfer these to manufacturing unit, So we start work on it to make the different furnitures. So work in process, when they are completed, so at the end we are getting the finished goods in the shape of sofas, in the shape of bed, in the shape of table, in the shape of chair, in the shape of cupboards, etc., etc. So these three accounts, these are called three different inventories accounts of the manufacturing process. Inventory, raw material inventory account, work in process inventory account, and finished goods inventory accounts. Hope you will understand from this explanation. Some of the students, they have said that to also explain in Pashto and Urdu, so I will also try to explain these in Pashto and Urdu as well. Is us raw material se tawai, raw material mawad kham tawai, har haga mawad da kam na chi finished goods judi gi hage ta munga sawai raw materials. Zamang sara pa manufacturing process ki dre inventory accounts judi gi. یعنی مطلب سدی دا کم مینوفیکچرنگ پروسیس چکو نو زمون سره دری سٹیپس پدې کې راځي اکارډنگ ٹو دی انوینٹری ون را میٹیریل دویم ورک ان پروسیس او دریم سدی فینیش گوڈز را میٹیریل هر هغه مواد دی چې هغه مونږه یوز کوو د څه لپاره د فینیش گوڈز د جوړولو لپاره یوز کوو او هغه اسینشل پارت دی را میٹیریل Example was a sadar kam. Example the raw material dadi. Let's suppose mung garments business thi. Garments matlab kapro business thi. Now the garments raw material se di kapla. Daga shan ka zamung furniture business bhi. Now the furniture raw material se di wood. Ha, work in process to am in دا را میٹیریل مونگا شفٹ کو پروسیسنگ پہ شروع کو کار پہ شروع کو مشینری تے ور فٹ کو نو را میٹیریل باند را میٹیریل پلس دا چم فیکٹری تا شفٹ شی مشینری تا نو ڈائریکٹ لیبر پہ کار کئی پخپلا ہونا رازی کا نا چھے دا سٹور نو راشی را منڈی کیا مشین نو دا پروسیسنگ پہ او نور ایکسپنسز ہون پہ دے راشی نور کاسٹ ان ڈائریکٹ کاسٹ لیٹ سپوز بجلی یوز کی گی دا آگے مشینری ڈیپریسیشن دی دا آگے مشینری چی کم بلڈنگ کے لگے دلے دا آگے ڈیپریسیشن دی سپروائزر لے سیلری ورکو چی دا مون دا ڈائریکٹ لیبر کار سپروائز کئی او ایٹسیکٹرا دا سے بلا شو نا دا ٹول پا پروسیسنگ کے شامل بھی کلے چی پروسیس یا خاص ٹائم بھی چی آگے کمپلیٹ شی او خاص طریقہ بھی نو سیسیوشی فینش گوڈز تے جوڑ چی خو ورکن پراسیز انوینٹری دا سیدہ چی دیتا نمونگا را میٹیریل بیا ویلی شو نا فینش گوڈز ویلی شو یعنی نیم پوختا چی ورطا منگا ویلی فینش گوڈز سے چلو چی بیا فینش گوڈز دا فینش فارم شی دا دی پیکنگ او پیکیجنگو شی اور ریڈی فار دا سیل چی بے خرز کو لکا مطلب سے شی لرگی منگا واخلو پاگے پراسیز شروع شی پراسیز نپس سے چی بیڈ تے جوڑ شی او اگا بیڈ یا چیئر یا ٹیبل وغیرہ یا اگا منگا خرز کو دا وزمان سرا انوینٹری فار دا مینوفیکچرنگ پرپسز. آئی ہوپ کہ آپ لوگ سمجھ گئے ہوں گے کہ را میٹیریل کیا چیز ہے, ورک ان پروسیس کیا چیز ہے اور فینش گوڈس کیا چیز ہے. را میٹیریل کو ہم مواد خام کہتے ہیں, ورک ان پروسیس اسی مواد خام کو جب ہم لے کے آتے ہیں مینوفیکچرنگ یونٹ میں تو ادھر مشینری میں ڈالتے ہیں. مشینری میں ڈالنے کے لیے اس پہ کاسٹ ہوتی ہے, پروسیسنگ ہوتی ہے, ایک خاص طریقہ ہوتا ہے, اس کے بعد یہ فینش گوڈز میں تبدیل ہوتا ہے. تو ورک ان پروسیس کے بعد جب ورک ان پروسیس کمپلیٹ ہو جاتی ہے تو ہم فینش گوڈز حاصل کرتے ہیں اور اس فینش گوڈز کو ہم پھر ویئر ہاؤس میں سٹور کرتے ہیں اور پھر اس کو ڈیلیوری کرتے ہیں مارکیٹ میں. تو دس واز دا انوینٹری فار دا مینوفیکچرنگ کنسرن. اب یہی इस यही फ्लो ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कास्ट ही, कि हम क्या करते हैं, पहले डायरेक्ट मटेरियल लेते हैं, उस पर डायरेक्ट लेबर और फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड, फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड को हम इनडायरेक्ट कास्ट कहते हैं, जो कि फैक्ट्री में दे आर टेकन प्लेस इन फैक्ट्री। तो उसके बाद वर्क इन प्रोसेस स्टार्ट होती है, वर्क इन प्रोसेस जब कंप्लीट हो जाती है तो फिनिश गुड्स में चेंज हो जाता है, और फिनिश गुड्स को हम किधर करते हैं, फिर उसको हम सोल्ड आउट करते हैं। और ये डायरेक्ट मटेरियल, डायरेक्ट लेबर, फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड, दे टू कंबाइंड टेकन प्लेस प्रोसेसेस टेकन प्लेस व्हेन प्रोसेस इज कंप्लीट, सो दैट आर कन्वर्टिंग इनटू फिनिश गुड्स, एंड देन फिनिश गुड्स आफ्टर स्टोरिंग इन द वेयर हाउस, सो वी आर डिलीवरिंग टू द मार्केट। बट लुक इट, कीप इन अ माइंड दैट व्हेन वी परचेज द रॉ मटेरियल्स, when we purchase the raw material, so raw material have some cost, we pay some price to purchase the raw material, so they have some cost. Similarly direct labor, so in does not in free direct labor work for us, so we pay. Similarly factory overhead, some indirect expenses take our place. So they, all these activity have some cost. So when they are put into the process, so some processing cost also taken place, and at the end we are converting it to finished goods. The finished good packing and packaging should taken place. So all these steps have include some cost. So let's suppose here at this stage, up to this stage, we say that per unit we consume, in a manufacturing unit consume $10. How much? $10. So this $10 is the cost of the goods. This is called cost of the goods. And now we sold out it. So we say that the goods which we sold out, their cost is $10. Why? Why we are calculating this cost? The reason is that one, to fixing the sale price, we need the cost price. If we don't know about that, the cost price, so how we can be able to fixing the sales price? One reason. Second one reason, for the controlling purpose, we also calculating the cost. Look it, when we take, when we manufacture the finished goods, and when we make the calculation, so the cost was $10. Oh, this is too much costly. Our competitors, let's suppose they are, their cost price is 7 and our cost price is 10. So this will help the manager that where is the problems. Either we purchase the raw material costly, or either our direct labor is costly, or either our processing unit is costly, like we are using outdated machinery, so their consumption is too much high. We are taking too much repair and maintenance cost, or the direct labor or indirect labor in the factory overhead, let's suppose indirect labor is costly. So what is the reason? So on the basis of that, then the management took the decision. So that's why to calculate the cost price, this is too much important. So this is the flow of the manufacturing cost. In this way, we can manufacture the finished goods and then sold out it. Cost of goods sold statement. So cost of the goods sold statement, now this statement is too much important. They play vital role in the cost accounting, and it provides us the necessary information in fixing the sale price. One, to control the cost of the different manufacturing parts. And similarly, while we are fixing the sale price, so on the basis of that, similarly to finding out the gross profit, so for that purpose, we need to make the cost of goods sold statement. In cost of goods sold statements, the different sections they take place. So inshallah, in the upcoming class, we will discuss in details the CGS statement. Now I will repeat this one, that the inventory of manufacturing cost. Now, inventory and manufacturing cost ki among sarasidhi, raw material inventory, work in process inventory, or finished goods inventory. Raw material mawad kham tawirishi, work in process pa dagh mawad kham chi munga kam process shuru ku. The sadapara, to get the finished goods, chi finished goods munga hasil ku. Now they ta munga sawai work in process wai. At the end, work in process chikala complete shi, no finished goods inventory ti judi ki. The finished goods, haga goods di chi aga munga sold out ka upa market ki. Yani the sales da para amada vi, ready vi. Ya flow of manufacturing se di, direct materials munga purchase ku. Ta aga direct labor karu ki, so indirect overhead cost shi, work in process ta complete change shi. Work in process chikala complete shi, finished goods ta change shi, aw finished goods بیا کمپنی سے کبھی آغا سولڈ آؤٹ کئی چی آغی تا منگا سوائی کاسٹ آف گوڈ سولڈ وائی اور دا کاسٹ آف گوڈ سولڈ دا اماؤنٹ یا دا پرائز چی کم دے دا معلوم اول دا پارا منگ یو سٹیٹمنٹ جوڑو چی آغی سٹیٹمنٹ تا منگا سوائی لی شو کاسٹ آف گوڈ سولڈ سٹیٹمنٹ دا دے دا پارا وی ہیو آ سیپریٹ چپٹر آن اٹ سو انشاءاللہ ان دا اپ کمنگ کلاسز وی ول سٹارٹ پریکٹیکل ورک آن اٹ तो हम क्या करेंगे फिर इस पे प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करेंगे कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड्स सोल्ड स्टेटमेंट पे. अभी तक इतना काफी है. इंशाल्लाह विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास.